In my last videos, we looked at how stars live out their lives. Now let's see what happens to a star when it runs out of fuel. A star like the Sun fuses hydrogen into helium, and then helium into carbon. The carbon never gets burnt because it never gets hot enough. Once all the helium turns to carbon, fusion will stop and gravity will take over. The carbon is pulled into a very dense ball. This is called a white dwarf. White dwarfs are about the size of the Earth, but they weigh as much as the Sun. They're very dense and totally degenerate. Degenerate matter is very strange. Ordinarily, if you add material to an object, the object gets bigger. But if you add mass to a white dwarf, it gets smaller. When you add mass, gravity goes up, so you need more pressure. Pressure in a white dwarf comes from electron degeneracy. To get more electron degeneracy pressure, you raise the density. So the white dwarf gets smaller. If you continue to add mass, its radius gets smaller and smaller, but it can't get smaller than zero. At a certain point, electron degeneracy cannot fight off gravity. You have reached the Kondrat-Aikar limit, the maximum mass a white dwarf can have, 1.4 solar masses. After that, it collapses into a neutron star, which we'll discuss later. White dwarfs don't do fusion, but they're still very hot, and so they glow. Eventually, they'll cool down and stop glowing, but this takes trillions of years. That's longer than the age of the universe. It's never happened. Large stars can burn heavier elements, but eventually they reach iron. Iron has the highest binding energy of any element. It's the most stable nucleus. Once you reach iron, you're out of options. There are no nuclear reactions that can produce energy. This kills the star. The star dies in a giant explosion, a supernova. This explosion is triggered by a small change in the core. The core stops producing heat and starts to contract. As the core contracts, several things happen that accelerate this. The core contracts faster and faster because of two things: photodisintegration and electron capture. As the core contracts, gamma rays are produced that break the iron into helium and hydrogen. This nuclear action doesn't produce energy. It does the opposite. It removes energy. Removing energy causes the pressure to drop and the core to collapse even faster. Then there's electron capture. An electron can be captured by a proton and turned into a neutron if the electrons have enough energy. And this will happen when a star is collapsing. A collapsing star is very dense. At high densities, electrons are forced into high energy states. These electrons now have enough energy to combine with the protons into neutrons. As we remove electrons, we remove electron degeneracy pressure, which causes the core to collapse even faster. For millions of years, the star had enough pressure to resist gravity. But in a few seconds, it's gone. Photodisintegration and electron capture remove all the pressure supporting the star. The star violently contracts. The entire star is in free fall. Imagine taking an object as heavy as the Sun and dropping it thousands of kilometers. That's how much energy is released in an instant. The material bounces off the core, ejecting a giant cloud of dust and gas. These explosions can be as bright as all the stars in a galaxy combined. In the year 1054, there was a supernova that was so bright you could see it in the middle of the day. It left behind the Crab Nebula. In the core of the star, the electrons and protons combine into neutrons. It becomes a neutron star. In a white dwarf, pressure came from electron degeneracy. But in a neutron star, pressure comes from neutron degeneracy. Neutron stars are extremely dense. They're the size of a city, but they contain the mass of several stars. Neutron degeneracy is the final obstacle to complete gravitational collapse. If a dead star has enough gravity to overcome neutron degeneracy, then there's no holding back. The mass will collapse to a single point, a black hole singularity. At this point, gravity has achieved ultimate victory. Black holes have so much gravity that even light cannot escape. We've now seen the life journey of many different kinds of stars. Now let's review the many different paths a star can take. If you start with a mass below 1% of the Sun, you don't have any fusion, you don't have a star. From 1% to 8%, you have a brown dwarf, which can burn a little hydrogen too before it dies. Above 8% of the Sun, you have true stars that can turn hydrogen into helium through the proton-proton chain. Stars below 0.3 solar masses are cold, red, and dim. They're fully convective. They never get hot enough to burn helium, and so they end up as helium white dwarfs. Stars as big as the Sun are hotter. They have radiative cores and convective outer envelopes. When they run out of hydrogen in the core, they burn it in a shell around the core and become red giants. Their cores are now made up of helium and become degenerate. The temperature rises. When it's hot enough to burn the helium, it burns in an explosive helium flash. The star then burns helium, first in the core, then in a shell around the core. The star becomes a red giant a second time. Eventually, it runs out of helium and becomes a carbon white dwarf. Above 1.5 solar masses, stars are hot enough to do CNO fusion. They have convective cores and radiative outer envelopes. They burn helium before they become degenerate, so they don't have helium flashes. They burn helium in the core and then in a shell. Heavy stars have powerful superwinds that blow off much of their top layers, forming a planetary nebula. Depending on their mass, these stars can end up as carbon, oxygen, or neon white dwarfs. Above 8 solar masses, a star can burn hydrogen, helium, carbon, oxygen, neon, and silicon. Finally, once the core is filled with iron, the star is doomed. The core collapses, and the star explodes as a supernova, leaving behind a neutron star or a black hole. For more astronomical videos, please click to subscribe.